In the last two lessons of our course, we're going to discuss two topics that many people think are the sum of psychology. That's mental disorders and their treatments. However, as we've talked about in the last 14 lessons, that this isn't all psychology has to offer. And as we've said before, many psychologists have different opinions on different things, and mental disorders and their treatments are two of those things. In fact, many government agencies question the way we diagnose mental disorders, but we'll get into that in a little bit. For now, let's go to Susan for an important note on the upcoming lessons.
As we discuss with many of the topics, such as consciousness, arousal, and stress, we can use the idea of a continuum to look at what is considered normal and what is considered not normal. And that's what makes diagnosing mental disorders so problematic and challenging, in that we have to determine what is too far on the continuum to be considered normal. Now here when we say normal, we're talking about that in a statistical sense and not necessarily a value judgment. Now psychologists who study mental disorders do so to understand, treat, and prevent human misery when behavior falls outside of the normal range on that continuum. Many people find this area of psychology very interesting. And although the way society has treated people with mental illness has evolved greatly, there are still cross-cultural differences in the way people view and treat individuals with mental illness.